season's greetings from WNDS, the Winds of New England. WNDS Sports and Tri-State Megabucks present Candlepin Stars and Strikes.
Oh, look at this. Look at that! He got it! Spread Eagle for a spin!
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is sponsored in part by Rockingham Toyota Dodge Nissan.
Looks good. Looks good. It's gonna go. It's gonna go.
Candlepin Stars and Strikes is produced in conjunction with the New Hampshire Candlepin Bowling Association. And now your hosts, Doug Brown and Dan Murphy.
Hi, everybody, and welcome once again to Park Place Lanes and Candlepin Stars and Strikes here on the Winds of New England. Glad to have you along, and especially glad that you've made us part of your holiday weekend. Thanks for joining us, Doug Brown, along with Dan Murphy. And you've joined us on a good day because we've got a hot bowler here. Joe Tavernese won three matches in a row, and now he's going to try and run the table and get into the Tournament of Champions.
He's been hot here, and I know the bowler he's bowling against has been hot off the lane, I mean, out of the lanes here, not on television, and I bowl with him every week, and he's been hot, too. So it shapes up, like I said last week, as a real good match.
All right, let's set it up for you. First of all, our number five seed from Lynn, Massachusetts, looking for his fourth straight win, Joe Tavernese.
Okay, averaging 125, high single 207, roll-off score 663.
And his winning scores here have been on the rise every week. He had a 370 3 weeks ago, and then back-to-back 400s to get to this point. So now he's looking for his fourth straight win, and in order to do it, he will have to face our number one seed from Bedford, New Hampshire, after a big roll-off, Rich Clark.
Okay, Rich averaging 128, high single 192, which he hit in the roll-off, and his roll-off score, top roll-off score in the roll-off, was 719.
So that sets you up for the match itself, and of course, big money on the line as well, 500 to the runner-up, 1,000 to the winner today. The winner also gets the automatic qualifier into the Tournament of Champions, which will come in the spring. And also, we have our bonus ball contest at the end of the hour, which is going to be worth $170. So this could be a very lucrative hour here on Stars and Strikes. Stay with us. We'll come back and start our championship match, Rich Clark and Joe Tavernese, right after these words. Number one, Joe Tavernese, with that 663 roll-off score, getting into the number five spot, but he's made it pay off with three straight wins, throwing back-to-back 400s the last 2 weeks, and now he gets a shot at our number one seed, Rich Clark, who threw that whopping 719 in the roll-off. Joe Tavernese, by the way, with that 663, beat out Neil Gosselin by just six pins for the fifth and final spot. And now here he is all the way to the finals. And the 10 for Joe. The warning is out. That's how Joe started last week's show, with a 10, and he had a 174.
So you're saying now is a strike? Following the same script? Not this week. Be a nice spare if he can make it, though, on the 2, 4, and 6. Piece of wood in between the 2 and the 4, and also one right behind the 6 pin. No.
Nothing doing. So a couple of open frames for Joe Tavernese. First time in 4 weeks he's done that. And now Rich Clark, the left-hander from Bedford, New Hampshire. Mentioned that high single, Dan, 192. That was in the third game of the five-game roll-off. Good time to have it. The only better time would be here on TV.
Well, they shoot at the 4 and 10. And all kinds of lumber. Looks like he goes right at the 4 pin. The one in the back should take out the 10 pin, I would think. Yes, just like that.
So Rich Clark gets his first mark up on the board in the first frame using the wood. Rich has been with us several times over on the Saturday show, but this is his first time here on singles competition on Sundays. 5 on the spare.
Four horsemen plus the nine.
Just a little light on the head pin. Rich backing off, that wood still moving around. Box for Rich and an early six pin lead.
Full on the head pin, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 10. To catch a piece of that four pin in the wood at the same time. Missed that, but he got a break on it. 6 and 10, and he'll leave the 7 for a 9 box.
Joe Tavernese in his 3 wins, a 370, a 404, and a 413. So the last 3 weeks, he's averaged just a shade under 132 a game, which is about 7 pins higher than his league average.
Three and five pins. That wood doesn't go by the five.
No, nope. He's got it. Mark number one for Joe Tavernese. Last week he had 13 marks, but he had a double strike early, a run of 6 consecutive marks, and put that semifinal match away in the early going. Rich Clark now carries a couple of extra pins. The 2 and the 5. Oh, wow.
I was a little bit behind himself that time. Released the ball just a little too soon, left it to the left, and wasn't enough to carry the 5 pin. 35 through 3. 7 pin advantage early in the match.
Rich is the manager of Clark's Farm in the Manchester area, and he and his wife Cindy have 2 young children, 3.5-year-old Lauren and 18-month-old Brandon, both of whom are here. All 3 of them are here, I should say.
That's right. Yeah, neither of them drive yet. They had to come down with the mother.
Oh, how about it? Almost from the back door.
He missed that one badly to the right, but was able to hit the 5 pin and then come back for a couple, but he missed the object pin being that 2 pin.
Well, a chance for Joe Tavernese to take the lead. Working on the spare. But he does not, just 4 on the fill.
Trying to make it 2 in a row. Not quite, 5 and 8 left. And a 10, 52 after 5.
Big first ball for Joe that time. He leaves the 8 pin.
Wants the wood to get out of the way of the 8 pin. He can probably play the 1 on the right, but there's a double piece there, so that's what he's going to try, though.
Got
nice
it.
Nice shot.
Is that one of those experience plays that you always talk about?
Yeah.
Using
well,
the wood like that? Or?
Well, not only experience, but that was a smart play that way. For me, it's the 8 pin all by itself, nothing in front of it, and a wood to the right, and I play. I like this. Shoot at something possibly a yeah. foot long rather than something that's 2.5 inches. So. That's called experience.
And the spare for Rich Clark, his second. And a big fill. Taps the seven, but it won't go over.
That'll give him 63, an 11-pin advantage. Guess got to watch this wood, because it might snap in front of the seven. There's a double piece there. He might want to try to avoid the front one. Nope, tries the right straight back. Nice shot, two in a row.
First time either bowler's been able to put back-to-back marks together here. Rich Clark in the lead. Joe cannot split it up. He'll take seven on the mark.
Six, seven, ten. Six and ten with a double piece of wood in front of it.
Can he fly it? Almost. And a nine. Joe Tavernese from Lynn, Massachusetts, where he lives with his wife, Sharon, and children Jolene and Joe Jr. Joe works as the manager of the Metro Bowl, where he does a lot of his bowling, and he's done a lot of fine bowling here over the last 3 weeks. Now into the fourth.
A slower start, I should say, this week than definitely last week.
Remember, this streak started for Joe when he was 29 pins behind going into the third game in week one against Rick Barassa, and he came back to win that match. And Rich Clark is again going to leave the seven pin. Second time in a row, he's moved it, but not knocked it over. And again, he's got plenty of wood out front. Drives it through for another spare. That's three in a row. Rich is in a bit of a groove right here.
Three marks in a row and two solid nine-pin drops on the first two. Increases his lead to 14 plus this one.
Rich missed the head pin, but almost had himself another nine drop.
Just the one and the six pins left, two pieces of wood in between. Catch the head pin, he's got a chance to make it four in a row.
Oh, he got it. Fine shot. I'm not sure if he wanted to play it on the outside, but it carried fourth mark in a row. Oh, Joe Tavernese with the big number one.
Six and nine left.
No.
Just sliding by the six.
That could be a big miss right there. Rich beginning to pile up a lead. Brooklyn side hit this time. He'll have the five and the six. You don't see this for a spare leave very often.
It's tough because the wood is in quite deep too.
He's trying to do it, and this is his only play, but it just didn't work. So a 107 opening game for Joe Tavernese, the lowest opening game he's had in his 4 weeks here. Meanwhile, Rich Clark in a little groove right here. Four marks in a row, getting big fills. Not this time, though. Just four. Everything but the head pin.
Make it 123 through nine.
And a 26-pin lead, as you see, for Rich Clark with one box to go. Wow.
Wow was right. Missed the head pin, leaves just the eight pin. That's a difficult
nasty pieces. Wood moving,
yeah,
though.
I was going to say, difficult wood out front.
Now, it's very deceiving from that camera shot, but that wood is 3 feet almost in front of the 8-pin. Yeah,
front piece is going to, I believe, slide to the left and the other two to the right.
Oh, carried it through with the ball.
Drove right the ball right straight through everything. 133 plus the bonus.
Six spares in this first game. For Rich Clark, chance for a 140 game here. And he will have his 140 game. 141, in fact, with the 8-fill. And a 34-pin lead after game one for Rich Clark. It's championship week here on Candlepin Stars and Strikes. At the end of the hour, Rich Clark now to start game two. Thanks for joining us today here on Stars and Strikes. We appreciate you making us part of a busy weekend and hope you have a safe, healthy, and happy Christmas season. It'll be a Merry Christmas for one of these two bowlers, whoever makes it to the Tournament of Champions, plus a check for $1,000.
Two full on the head pin. You have the 1, 2, 7, and 10.
And it'll be an 8-box. We have not seen a strike yet in today's show.
That's surprising. These two bowlers.
Full again for Rich Clark. Driving right through the center of the rack. He just missed giving that a real run. He just missed the 2-pin on the way by. Well, two open frames. Joe Tavernese looking to make a comeback here, as he did 3 weeks ago, trailing by 34.
Four horsemen with a little help behind the 6 and 10. Piece of wood, now it's rolling back a little bit. No, too full.
Ten. Almost had the four horsemen on the other side. Kicked out the 7-pin. And Joe can't make it happen. Still with just two marks so far in the match. Out of the eyes of Rich Clark as he approaches the lane.
2, 4, 5, 7, cluster of four in the left-hand corner, no wood.
And gets it.
Just splitting the two and the five, just enough to have the 2-pin carry the 4 and 7. Right there.
Just slides by the head pin. Oh,
that close to two in a row.
Sent a pin spinning near the 8, but not enough to take it out.
.42 after four for Rich. Joe Tavernese for his third and fourth, still trailing by 32.
Joe really needed that spare. He was working on a six box drought going back to game one.
He's been shooting a lot at the 1-2-4, the 1-3-6, and something else. So he's gonna get on the head pin a little more consistently now with that first ball.
Like
that's
there.
What happens when he does. He's gonna hit it two or
yes.
three times and finally strike on spare.
And that takes us to a break. Joe Tavernese trying to make up some ground on Rich Clark in this championship match. We'll be back.
Here are the winning numbers from last night's Tri-State Megabucks drawing.
The left-hander, Rich Clark. Not only did he finish first in that roll-off, he finished first by a wide margin, one of the biggest margins we've ever had, 41 pins between Rich and second-place Brian Fuller.
And to do that, he had to make shots similar to this, I'm sure. You know, just sliding by the three-pin. That was one he didn't have to be too cute on. He could have fired right at the three-pin. And with the angle of the wood, it would have shot it toward the seven pin.
Instead, it's an eight. .191 halfway through the match for Rich Clark. Of course, when it gets a little bit later in the match, we'll be, oh, there's a big strike for Rich, his first after seven spares.
And that was a quick one. His pocket, in left-hander being the 1-2, the ball goes through the pins, gives you a little better pin action, and certainly couldn't get better pin action than that.
Joe Tavernese on a strike and driving right through the middle.
And he's just seven on the strike. Phil gives him 56 through four.
Nice pinning on the 10. That lead down to 18 now, but Joe opposite that strike by Rich Clark. Oh, he matches it.
That's the ball he was throwing last week.
I would say the battle is joined now.
Yes, you're right. Tripping that four pin out of there. And those were some of the balls he was throwing last week against Brian Fuller. Especially the first game. Well, Rich goes through the middle on his strike. Manages a nine, Phil.
Just missing the head pin on the way by. No on the four horsemen.
Can't help but think the wood might have cost him that shot. It was right in the 1-2 pocket.
Two open frames. Joe Tavernese working on a strike.
Yeah, last time he was working on a strike, he moved over to lane 32 and right through the middle. This time he slides by to the left. Four horsemen plus the seven pin. Four horsemen on the right.
We've seen a lot of the four horsemen in this match. Both bowlers. Oh, great shot.
They're on strike.
Lead now 16. There you see the replay, minus this ball, so he can push it under 10 pins.
Look out.
Whoa. Oh.
And another spare.
may very well even this thing up.
Well, he's got a chance to take the lead, really. Six pins, and he still has a ball working against the nine box. Final two frames for Rich Clark, second game. Opened with a 141, trailed off this game, at least right through eight, is only 87. Half Worcester right.
Oh, great shot. Not quite good enough, though. That could have been a big confidence booster right there for Rich. He's had only two marks in this second game after a 141 opener. Very nearly had another half Worcester.
Nice spare.
This one.
Nice spare. 107 plus the bonus.
Through the heart again, he'll take six. 113 and a two-game total of 254 for Rich Clark. Now, we shall see what Joe Tavernese does here, working on a spare in the eighth. Just four. Not enough to take the lead.
Drops the lead to two, I believe. Opposite of 10 box. Not close to a mark, so he'll have to mark the last box to have a chance for the lead or to keep it close. Well, it's going to be close anyways, but closer, I should say. At 10 box, 129 through nine.
Yeah, it figures to be single digits, right. Regardless at this point.
Three, five, and nine. The nine's the problem pin. Sleeper in the back.
Oh,
that's
yes.
A great shot.
Yeah, how much of a psychological edge will this be for Joe Tavernese erasing this 34-pin lead here in the second game?
Well, he needs eight, I believe, to tie the match up. How about that?
Eight you are. 147. And we're going to have a one-game match for the championship right now, all even after two. We'll be back on Stars and Strikes in a minute. Well, here we are. Championship week, down to one game, all even. Joe Tavernese, who's won three matches in a row, against Rich Clark, who is making his first appearance in singles competition here on Stars and Strikes. What about that as a factor here, Dan? Obviously, Joe has been through these kinds of matches many, many times.
No, and he's got the momentum going in. I mean, you've got to give the experience factor to Joe. There's no question about it. He's been here so many times, not necessarily on our show, but on many of the bowling shows. Rich Clark, he's only been bowling for five or six years. He's come a long ways very fast.
And but, has been very hot.
That's right.
Coming into this show.
This is when you find out. This will be either a real educational experience for him or really create a monster with Rich Clark. Can beat the likes of Joe Tavernese. So it's a lot riding on the factor. Now you just take those two factors, the experience factor and having been here so many times, now you add $1,000 in front of him. Now you add the Tournament of Champions in front of him. And yikes.
Well, Joe with the spare in the first, but the fill cost him. So he only got 23 in those first two boxes. And the next time you see the computer, it will be corrected.
Well, Rich, that's a nice one to start off with. The two and the four. No problem there.
That is mark number 10 for Rich Clark. Joe Tavernese has 9 to this point. Oh, big first ball that time, and kicks out the 10 pin.
That was a big break there. He put the ball right in the pocket, though.
First, it didn't look like that 10 pin would go. Two marks in a row for Rich Clark.
Certainly showing no signs right there of any nervousness. I can understand the first one, piece of wood in front. You're supposed to make those. You have to make those. The single pin's another thing, and he showed he can make those under pressure, too. 4-7, 6-10. Tough choice. Go 4-7, sleep that wood across, but it might come in contact with a piece of wood in front of the 6-10, or you snap the one in front of the 6-10. Let's go on the other side.
Don't forget, next weekend here on the Winds of New England, we'll be back with more bowling action for you. On Saturday, we will be airing an episode of Candlepin Skins that was preempted, if you will, by
Mother Nature.
Exactly.
Yeah, right.
A transmitter went out several weeks back, so you'll be seeing that show that you missed.
Nice try by Joe Tavernese. Be open, three boxes in a row. Didn't mean you dropped your duck.
That's quite all right.
But, I just knew he's going to make a great 10. So. Oh, he's spinning well.
So on Saturday, we will have Candlepin Skins. It'll be a new show because it didn't air when it was supposed to back on October the 28th. So we'll have that one for you next Saturday. And then on Sunday, we will start a brand new series here on Candlepin Stars and Strikes. Rich Clark with a quick double-digit lead here in the third game. And his third mark in a row.
If you're wondering, the two qualifiers now, Bob Kelly and Dan Broder. Bob Kelly leads the pack at 410 and Dan Broder at 362. So remember, the winning total here will determine their temporary seeding. Another big 9 drop, and he's taking a little bit of command in this match right now, through 3 boxes anyways. This could be a game breaker right here. Go to the break with 4 marks in a row.
Oh, yes, he's right on it. Rich Clark is having a whale of a third game here, and he's piling up a lead. It's at 22 now with a mark working on Joe Tavernese. We will decide the championship when we return on Stars and Strikes. Joe Tavernese. That's what he's done today, but he will need a bunch more marks to win this match now, because he may be down by as many as 30 when Rich Clark fills the spare in the fourth.
Not an easy spare here with a 7-8 and 2 pieces of wood really blocking his shot. He would like to get at that wood in front of the 7 pin. Oh,
no, couldn't get there.
What that does is just give him one less box to put a mark in. And bowling first, you've got to be able to put the marks up.
Well, it's going to be another open box for Joe, leaving him not much time. Eight box. And now Rich Clark with a 22-pin lead plus this first ball. Oh, look out! Somehow the 9-pin stays up. But that is 3 9-pin drops on these 4 marks that
Rich has scored in this third game.
You wish you'd be ambidextrous here and throw with your right hand to buy the front piece of wood. Him left-hander coming across doesn't have much room to get by that front piece of wood.
Notice,
didn't have to. Played that front piece, five in a row.
Notice, Dan, that it seems like on every box, Rich is making that motion with his left arm before he throws, just trying to remind himself to keep it smooth, keep it steady, make sure his mechanics are good. Carries a couple of extra pins. He's at 90 through five, and he's got a bigger lead now than he had at the end of game one. He didn't miss that by much either.
One, three, and four pins left. And right now he's in the driver's seat.
Well, of course, he's in the driver's
seat. Don't want to do that, though.
You know, he's got a 36-pin lead with four boxes to go. But, of course, you don't want to look too early. But from our vantage point back here, we can look ahead and see that Rich needs a one. A 156 to tie Bob Kelly. 157 to take over the number one spot, which would mean he'd need a couple more marks.
And oh, it's going to go.
Joe Tavernese has a spare in the seventh.
He's still breathing. He's still alive.
Needs marks, though, Dan. Spares won't be
enough. Absolutely.
I need strikes, I should say. Spares won't be enough at this point for Joe. Even if he were to spare out, it wouldn't be enough. Probably. For another? Yes. Well, he's got two up there. Giving himself a fighting chance, anyway. But you have to feel if Rich were to be able to mount any offense here.
Yeah, one more mark here, and Joe's going to have to start throwing strikes. And it's always tough to throw when you need them.
Well, Richard's got a pretty nice setup here.
Yeah, you're not thinking about making this. You're just thinking about hitting that three pin. And if anything, miss to the left. Wood will help you. Oh, no.
Nope.
That's where you got to really bear down. Get that front pin. You have a lot of room for error to the left on that one. That might have taken it. 106. Lead now drops to 29. I suggest maybe Rich put another mark up here.
Well, he'll have a shot at
one.
Yet another nine drop. See that motion again with his left arm?
His situation here, again, if you want to miss left gives you another chance, but you certainly don't want to pull it right.
Oh, he's all over it.
Nice shot there. Clutch mark in the eighth.
That's mark number 15 for Rich Clark. And that requires strikes now from Joe Tavernese.
Yeah, you can't assume that Rich is going to give him a break on the fill. He's going to go out and do it yourself.
No,
that
Mike
should just about do it. Well, Joe had a great run. It just, and I honestly counted him out after the first game. It didn't look like he had it going. He came right back the second game to pull even. Rich can sit back now and fire away. Now you got the match, and you just watch the total. And knowing Rich, I'm sure he knows what the totals are.
Well, Rich, if he were to go strike, spare, strike his last time up, he would have exactly one. I take it back. He doesn't have to do that.
No, he doesn't need that many.
He could get a 147, make it a 157, and pass Bob Kelly without doing that.
This is an important ball here. He has to have a decent fill.
For Joe Tavernese, a 362.
Rich already at 370.
And he carries the seven.
Well, it's the same shot. He pulled it far to the right. This time he doesn't get the benefit of the wood in between the three and the six.
No, he just slides by. So now it'll take a double strike.
You may see those three pins in his sleep.
.133 through nine. So Bob Kelly's 410 is safe.
Danny Broder's 362 isn't.
No. And Rich will not quite get to 400, but
he'll be in between Bob Kelly and Dan Broder.
Terrific match for Rich Clark. A 9, a 142 under pressure, 396, and the championship for Rich Clark. We'll be back to see if we can't give some more money away in the bonus ball contest when we come back. Welcome back to Stars and Strikes. Doug Brown along with Dan Murphy, and a match fitting of a championship week. Joe Tavernese drops behind, comes back, ties it up, and then Rich Clark hits him with five marks in a row in the third game.
Well, you know he's got that ability, and I really honestly counted Joe out after the first game. His ball looked flat. He looked a little tired, but boy, show me some spark there that second game and that finesse on the ball, and he came right back and tied it up. And But Rich came out in four in a row in the last game, and that was it.
That's a big part of the game, that finesse. That's what you like to use, right?
Well, when we get our age, yeah, finesse. We need all the finesse we get. Finesse means a piece of wood this big in front of single pins.
Finesse being another word for no power, I guess, would be, right?
I don't know. Good enough to beat the host here.
That's true. We won't go any farther with this. Let's call up Joe Tavernese. A terrific run by Joe, and he will take the second place prize money, $500, and boy, there you go with the check, sir.
Thank you very much.
Boy, I'll tell you, coming back in that second game like you did, I mean, that had to make you feel pretty good, because it looked tough after game one.
You ain't kidding. I was just running out of gas. I just couldn't get nothing going. The ball was flat, and then the second string just perked me up a little bit more, and then Rich came out with that five in a row, and it just put me right back again. So, but it was great. He bowled excellent, and I deserved it.
Well, you waited a long time to finally come on here, and now we're seeing a lot of you.
Yeah,
so perhaps we'll see you again before the end of the season.
Sure you will.
All right, Joe. Thanks very much. Congratulations. And now Rich Clark for the bonus ball. We have $170 in the bonus ball contest, and we are desperate for our first winner of the year. So no pressure, Rich, but we're just looking for this first winner here. $170. Well, let's see. It's a 7, so we've got a chance. Let's see. We'll check it out. $170 on the line. Not a match for Vincent Tutain from Manchester, New Hampshire. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that somewhat close to right, Vincent. Congratulations for having your card drawn. We will send you a consolation gift, and we'll be up to $180 next week. And here's our champion. Step right on in here so we can get you and daughter Lauren on the air. Hi, Lauren. Hi. Lauren's come up here, but she may not talk. But I'm sure you will, especially after, boy, that was a terrific performance in the third match. We talked about this a little bit, you know, kind of the experience versus youth theme that we set up in that third game. And we got to think this may be kind of a breakthrough match for you, beating one of the veterans of the game.
Well, yeah, I just wanted to, you know, I always preach to myself, if I bowl my game, you know, I can bowl with anybody. I just don't want to beat myself. So that's why every one of those singles was so key, and it was nice to hit them. So, yeah, it felt good, and you know, every one of these wins definitely helps your confidence.
Well, this puts you into the Tournament of Champions in the spring, so you don't have to worry about that. 396, good qualifying score. That puts you in second place, at least for now. And, one more thing, $1,000. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
And a nice time to have it right before the holidays.
Yeah.
So,
Merry Christmas to everybody.
That's right. And to you especially. Congratulations, Rich. Thanks very much. Nice to see you, Lauren. Next time you come up, we'll do an interview, all right? Lauren's just 3 and a half, so she's still a little bit shy about doing those interviews, but next time maybe she'll grant us one. Well, a terrific championship match, and maybe so. Maybe a breakthrough match for a guy like Rich Clark that you said has not been bowling for very long, but has been bowling very well lately.
He's got to get over those little plateaus, and he made a big step today, and he bowled very well, and he's a lot of confidence right now.
All right, don't forget, next weekend, it's another holiday weekend, but we'll be right back to business here on the Winds of New England. Don't forget, a reminder, on Saturday at noon, we will have Candlepin Skins. It'll be the show that
originally was scheduled to air on Saturday, October 28th, but was knocked off the air due to a power outage at the television station. So it'll be a new show, one that was supposed to air back in October. So that'll be Saturday at noon. And then Sunday at noon, of course, we'll be back here at Park Place Lanes to start a brand new series here on Stars and Strikes. Until then, for Dan Murphy and our whole crew, we'd like to wish all of you a very, very Merry Christmas and a happy holiday week. And join us next week, everybody. Thanks very much.